It sizzles, it smokes, it's juicy. It's the Impossible Burger version 2.0 from Impossible Foods, and
it was born here
in a big white rectangular lab in Redwood City.
There was a version that I bit into and was like, wow, this is game changer.
She's Celeste Hohl-Schiedinger, Director of Research and Development at Impossible.
We got a better process to how to do it.
She studied biochemistry at UC Santa Barbara and was hired on by Impossible when she was in grad school back in 2012.
You were one of the first 10 employees.
Yes.
Was it hard to buy into the idea of what was going on here, or were you?
I was pretty much in.
The challenge? Create a plant-based burger that smells and tastes just like beef. The first goal? To find the ingredients.
We call this our bubble, but inside of this, we have instruments that are working much like our nose.
Inside the bubble, this instrument has one job, identify molecules associated with aroma, with flavor.
So of all the steps, I mean, this is kind of the first and foremost.
Yes.
Okay.
What is meat, and what are those flavors, and then how do we find plant ingredients that make those same flavors?
The biggest discovery along the way, heme. It's an essential molecule found in every living plant and animal, and it's what makes meat taste like meat. Scientists at Impossible used heme-containing protein from the roots of soy plants and inserted it into a genetically engineered yeast. They ferment the yeast, but instead of producing alcohol, the yeast multiply and produce a lot of heme.
That is our yeast that is growing up. That yeast, as it grows, it produces our heme protein, the like hemoglobin that we identified creates the flavor of meat.
So we have the flavor, but now we need the texture.
I knew they were onto something and I had to be involved.
And inside the test kitchen.
How many hours do you spend in the kitchen?
I couldn't even count.
We meet the head of culinary, Chef J. Michael Melton, who introduces us to the other key ingredients. We start with the protein. Right here, what looks like dry cereal is actually soy protein.
Think about us producing this on a large scale. It's sort of like a large KitchenAid mixer, so to speak. So we first hydrate it with a little bit of water, and we'll add some potato protein. So the potato protein actually adds some malleability to the product in its raw state. And upon cooking our product, it helps to bind to the water and help that soy protein create that texture and chew.
Next, we mix in all the important heme, providing that flavor, then some cellulose, then some sunflower oil and coconut fat. Those provide the sizzle on the grill or pan.
So just like that, now we have the product, and with the magic of TV, we can start cooking it.
The visual cues are gonna give you that familiar time to turn, so to speak. It's gonna pull that rich red color.
Three sliders, one with my name on it, little lettuce, tomato, time to take a bite.
Explain your first bite too while I take mine.
You know, it was with 1.0, and I gotta say the difference between 1.0 and 2.0 is drastically different, but still impressive. Again, the reason that I came to this company was after trying 1.0. So glad to be working on a product like this and sharing it with the world.
2.0 is so good, I'm gonna do a second bite.
Healthier? A bit. A 4-ounce Impossible Burger 2.0 patty is about 240 calories. A 4-ounce ground beef patty ranges from about 250 to 300 calories, depending on the fat content. Scientists say the Impossible Burger also contains less cholesterol, sodium, and fat compared to beef.
And sustainability is really, that's my passion. And my background in biochemistry makes me kind of primed to be able to solve these problems.
And you said a key word there, and that is sustainability.
Exactly.
You know, this isn't necessarily about making a burger that's healthier for you.
Of course, this is
a wider picture.
This is a wider picture. How do we as humans live more sustainably with this earth? And we think the best way to do that and provide a solution is to create tasty meat, that the consumer gets to make the choice. What do you want to eat? Do you want to eat something that is delicious, nutritious, and sustainable?
The simplicity of the ingredients allows them to mass produce, and they are. The staff has tripled in size at this plant in Oakland, and with the Impossible Burger coming to grocery stores, the company also struck a deal with OSI Group, a large meat manufacturer, which should help grow its production.
It really handled just like meat. It cooked like meat, it sizzled like meat, you could grill it, you could put it in tomato sauce, you could put it in every single application.
In the end, for Celeste, for Chef, they only ask one thing, something I often tell my children, just try it.
Take a bite. Don't be scared. Have that sensory experience and judge it for what it is.
Tastes great, looks great, smells great.
Hey, we're trying to create
an Impossible Burger, and it's a burger.
It's uncompromisingly delicious. We know that we can't do our mission without making it delicious, so that's what we're trying to offer all those meat lovers out there.
Chef, great job.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Appreciate it.